I met Meg when she was young, just coming out of college. She'd had a relatively pampered childhood, won her local town's beauty pageant.
The people here have always been friendly, helpful people with strong character. Our town sign boasts the fact that we are proud of our heritage. Now we have more to be proud of than ever.
We met in Valley Forge, Pennsylvania. She was spending her first post-college year as an AmeriCorps volunteer and doing some summer camp counseling. And I felt this was somebody who really had her act together. When that year ended, we moved briefly to South Portland, Maine, where Meg took a job as a crew member on a tourist boat. When her second year as an AmeriCorps staffer was approved, we moved to Erie, Pennsylvania.
Here I am, I'm back at you. Promised you I said I would, and here I am. I'm Skip Boyer, your host of the Skip Boyer Show right here on WLKK 1400 on the AM dial. Who do we have here, Naomi?
We have Lisa Johnson and Meg McLaughlin. And I'd like for Meg to tell us a little bit about AmeriCorps. What is AmeriCorps?
The AmeriCorps program is actually threefold in terms of the legislation. There is the AmeriCorps VISTA, which VISTA is a program that a lot of people are familiar with. It's been around for 30 years or so. And that's one arm that kind of came under the AmeriCorps umbrella. Our goal is not only to provide service to the communities, but to, as Lisa mentioned, to empower the individuals who are participating in the program.
Good morning and welcome to another edition of Issues Concerning Erie. I'm your host, Chuck Peters, and each week at this time we discuss issues affecting you, your family, and the community in which we live. And this morning I'm very happy to have with me Meg McLaughlin, who is the Northwestern Field Coordinator for the Pennsylvania Service Corps. What exactly is AmeriCorps?
AmeriCorps is a national program that was designed to essentially bring the Peace Corps home. It expanded on the concept of VISTA, which has been around for about 30 years now.
When her Erie year ended, we moved to a town near her parents' home in northern Maine. Meg found work at another nonprofit there. She applied for and was hired to be a full-time staffer with the American Red Cross in Rockland.
So for now, the waiting game on Samoset Road continues. Everyone's waiting to see if Mother Nature will continue her fight.
We're just keeping an eye on the situation and are prepared for shelter if the need arises to evacuate.
Last week, I interviewed Red Cross Representative Meg Woodcock, who talked about some of the things you should know and do to get ready for a hurricane. Could you explain to us the difference between a hurricane watch and a hurricane warning?
Absolutely. The hurricane watch is actually offered about 48 hours out from a storm to give people a chance to get ready and emergency preparedness officials to prepare the area for the effects of the hurricane. The warning is offered when the storm is much closer, there's a much more definite, it is going to hit this area, and that's when determinations are made as to evacuation.
She saw it an opportunity to move to a better Red Cross position and found it in disaster services at the American Red Cross in Boston. Meg said the best Red Cross job of all in disaster services was the state disaster lead position. I said, why don't you put together an application and see what happens? If you don't get it, at least you learn what you need to work on to get the next one. She put in an application and was hired as the state disaster lead for the Red Cross in Missouri. And now her career was really going places. When the airliner struck the Twin Towers of the World Trade Center in September 2001, Meg was in her car as soon as she got the nod, and she served as second-in-command for the volunteer coordination effort for 9/11, working with thousands of volunteer applicants. With that on her resume, she served as temporary disaster lead for Columbus, Ohio, and at the age of 29 was being actively recruited as disaster lead for San Diego. While all this was happening, Meg continued to sing. She came from a musical family. And she joined the St. Louis Harmony Chorus.